all go through trials. From our first steps to our first ride.
Always there is a voice inside our heads, pleading us to avoid taking that risk.
But through all the falls and broken bones,
there is another voice, urging us forward into potential pain and danger.
This is the unspoken language of longboarding.
Longboarding is the act of riding a long skateboard ranging from 24 to 80 inches. However, longboarding is not the same as skateboarding. While a skateboard is limited to low speeds and nice tricks, a longboard can be used for carving, downhill, slalom, freestyle, and sliding. The advantage of a longboard is the many different board configurations which give the rider more choice in the intended use of the board. In a general sense, a board consists of a base plate that mounts to the board and hangers that allow the wheels to be attached. Who invented longboarding isn't quite clear, though several groups have tried to take credit. It started in Hawaii, but was made popular in California by a group called the Z-Boys. Bunch of skaters who rode under the Dogtown label in the 1970s. The Z-Boys had a deep passion for boarding, and they seized every moment that they could get. They would often sneak into people's backyards, skate as long as they could in their empty pools, and then run when the police showed up. In 1976, the group disbanded and went their separate ways.
The idea was thought up by surfers when they realized that the rolling motion of the skateboard mimicked the motion of the waves. On days when the surf was low, or it was too rough to go in the water, the surfers could continue to ride the sidewalks. Later, a desire for a longer, smoother riding board led to the creation of the modern longboard. Skateboarding, which was developed in the late 1950s, shortly led to the idea of longboarding. It underwent a temporary hiatus during the 1960s, and only diehard skaters kept the sport alive. It was brought back to popularity by Frank Nosworthy, who breathed new life into the sport by inventing the urethane wheel.
Longboarding started out with the simplest board design, a deck, some trucks, and clay wheels. This type of board was considered unsafe and not very effective. However, in 1972, the same year as the Z-Boys got started, urethane skateboard wheels were invented. These wheels made longboarding smoother, safer, and more reasonable. Even today, urethane wheels are still used. Board types have also evolved over the years. For example, a board with a longer deck will allow more speed and stability, while a shorter board will be slower but more agile. Similarly, a board that is lower to the ground will be faster than a board that is higher. Deck materials range from various different types, from wood such as bamboo to synthetic materials such as carbon fiber. Creative and daring explorers of the sport also find ways to innovate every single day.
The sport of longboarding has reached an international level in recent years. The IDF, or International Downhill Federation, holds an annual World Cup for the world's fastest and bravest boarders. In 2013, the participants included, but are not limited to, Canada, Australia, the United States, France, South Africa, Switzerland, and Brazil.
So for some people, a longboard is just a plank of wood, or just a sufficient mode of transport.
But not for us.
We chose this sport because it allows the mind to wander free from the rigors of the daily grind.
Because every worry and every trouble slowly dissipates with every rush of wind and every soft kiss of sunlight.
It's these moments that consume the rider.
It is no longer about where he is going,
It is about what he is feeling.
And where he ends up is no longer up to him.
Whether heaven or hell, he arrives equally content with a satisfied mind and a heart of gold.
It's these moments that every great man desires.
It is this unheard language that every great man should hear.